Guten Abend, Shalom and good evening from Salzburg. I'm sitting now in the middle of on our campus Kuchl, small village south area of Salzburg. I studied industrial design and architecture, and maybe this is in the beginning a little bit part of my position on this campus. I'm working in the design and product management area, and the second study program is the forest products and timber construction area, and that means in both areas I'm responsible for the interior design. That means for the designers I try to talk about wood, and for the Department of Timber Construction, I try to talk about design. That means I'm between two chairs, I can say. This is our campus. I hope in a few months when the green grass is in front of us. And Campus Kuchl remains inspired by nature since 1995. That means we are now more than 25 years in this area of working with the nature or for the nature or for our future, let me say. On our campus, we have three study programs, and these study programs are very strongly related to our research and development areas. The first course is DPM, told you before, Design and Product Management, with the Design Research Salzburg, we call it Teresa. And we have three points where we are working for. This is the industrial design, furniture design, and the interior design department. Then HDB, forest products technology, with timber construction, the same topics, furniture design and interior architecture. And the third study program is SMB, Smart Building and Smart City. That means we're dealing with different proportions from the product design to the up to cities, I can say. It's a huge framework. For Austrians, it's very important because we have a very rich culture in biogenic materials. And for example, this is a building in Salzburg. It's over 500 years now standing in one special part. It's not in a museum. It's still standing 500 years in the same place. This is a building 250 years old. Everything is made out of wood, solid wood, not only one species, many different species. And this picture shows Donet. All of you know the different furnitures. 150 years ago. That means we have a very huge relationship to our biogenic materials, and that's the reason we trust them. Over the last 150 years, something changed, not only the colors, also the temperature. And for us, it's an education. For us, it is as a university, we have to react on these changes. How can we react? Just to give you a few numbers, we have to decarbonize now our total economy. One example in relationship to the building site, for example, concrete, usage of concrete in US for 100 years, 1900 to 1999, in comparison to China, they had the same amount of concrete in 3 years. That means we have a very dynamic situation now. And the question is, how can we deal with these circumstances? Some of our core values in research and development on our campus, for me as a designer and architect, it's very interesting that we are starting from the material perspective. That means we are able to develop new materials out of biogenic raw materials. And we are able to make the definition, what can we do, what can we produce out of them. It's not only wood, it's also fast growing plants on the outside fields. And of course, we are talking about how can we specify the working and the processing behind these new materials. In our design perspective, we are going to closed material cycles. That means we are looking behind these processes and try to have closed cycles for a circular economy. From a design perspective, we are working on the aesthetic consequences of sustainability. That means new materials need a new design language or a new architecture language. We cannot deal with the old style. If you can compare it now to with the car companies, the cars look nearly the same, but we changed dramatically the engines. But in my point of view, it's not enough to change the engine. You have to change the whole question about cars and mobility. Teaching on this campus in Kukri means we starting not from the age of 20, 21, 25. We're starting educating also kids. This was a project we did for kindergartens. We developed this furniture in the back, and this furniture shows 80 different possibilities to interact with experiments from the from medicine, from human bodies, going to physics, chemistry, and of course the living area of biology. This is very successful now, because in Salzburg nearly every second kindergarten now runs this project. There is a quote: "We are at war with nature. If we win, we are lost," from Hubert Reeves. And this is very strong related to our position now. That means we have to come up with a circular economy, and the circular economy is inspired by closed circles. It means we have to bring 100% from our materials return in this closed circle to create this circular economy. Circular economy means that if you are creating products, architecture, interior design, in the end of the life cycle, we should be able to divide these two circles. In the technical circle, that means the steel, the glass, the bricks, the concrete is going in this technical circle, and all the other materials coming out of the nature, they should go back to the nature. We call it the biological circle. That means for our product design, we have to keep in mind that after the life cycle, every part has its closed circle in the end. Two of my colleagues published this book about a circular economy in the design and product management area. And this is the process we are working on now. We are going from this linear economy line to a closed circle. Now I want to show you some examples. How can we bring this theory in reality? One of the examples is dealing with wood in Austria. And this graphic shows where the different qualities of wood coming from the forest, from foreign countries, and how much is going in which direction, in which kind of industry, in the paper industry, timber production, or somewhere else. And this is very interesting for us for researchers and for our study program to look very precise to all these numbers, to look for potentials. One potential we found out is bark in Austria. If you cut a tree, then almost 10% of a tree is bark. In our situation now, the bark is coming with the log to the sawmill, and they have no idea what to do. That means 10% in Austria means 2 million cubic meters per year. It's a huge, huge number, and of course it's a huge potential, but till now we have no ideas what to do with this bark. Here you see professors, farmers, part of the industry. We try to create a new process behind this potential. And on our campus, we have the facilities to produce new materials, for example, out of bark. We try to bring this raw material into a new material where we can speak about design potential, interior design potentials, and architecture. And not only it's a design perspective, it's also very interesting from the technical point of view. That means thermal insulation, that means protection against bacteria or burning situations and something else. For example, this is you see some foam structures. These are foams made out of tannin, and they are developed to substitute polystyrene. And they are biodegradable. They're coming from the bark, and they are going back to nature if you don't use them anymore. And on the right side, you see a detail from our building. Our building is a passive house. That means there's no heating needed to warm it up. The one aspect is material development. The second topic is development of structures. Structures are very, very interesting, very useful if you have different problems you have to deal with. For example, you have to make a ceiling and you have only small sticks or short sticks. How can you create a structure that you can go over a larger scale? These weaving structures in the lower side of my presentation, they are dynamic. That means they can change the shape. They are flexible. And here I see our students, they have to build the structures. It's not enough to make only the calculation and sit on the computer and say, okay, now it's working. We are going the scale one-to-one. That means we only believe our ideas and our concepts. It is really functioning. And here you see we are producing a dome. These connectors, they are 3D printed. And of course, they have to present their ideas in the end if they are successful. Yeah, now I'm coming to my talk. And with the first question, how much do your buildings weigh? This was a question Buckminster Fuller asked Norman Foster, and Norman Foster had no answer. He had to go home and do some calculations, and after a few weeks, he know, okay, my latest building has 5,000 tons. And I would say this is very important, how much do our concepts weigh? Because behind the tons of material, there are consequences in relationship to how much energy we need. What does it mean for our local resources? Are our concepts repairable, serviceable, reusable, recyclable, biodegradable? And of course, in our point of view, we have to generate employment, and it should be part of our education to educate people working in this direction. And of course, latest question, are they intelligent or are they really smart? I want to show three projects relating to our workshop, Happiness Pavilion. And the idea is that wood technology, timber construction, and design, if they're working together, then they create a new rhythm and vocabulary of a new architectural idiom. The first is a small product with a huge potential. We are looking for lightweight constructions. Lightweight constructions mean the energy behind the construction is very low. And for these questions, we had an interesting workshop with our colleagues in Istanbul. And we were searching in Istanbul for people hidden potentials, let me say. People, they have no homepage, they have no communication, but they have a very huge history in how they treat materials. And here you can see a basket weaving person from his seventh year up to now. He's working nearly every day with these materials. And what he's doing here on the left page, he's working on the different dimensions on this wooden stick. This is very interesting, and it is combined to the technology of Tonet in a way that if you change the dimensions through the stick, then of course you can come up with different solutions for your products. That means we get inspired by his competences, and we try to develop his competences in a certain way. In this situation, we had the idea to try it out in a stool. This is a picture in our lab downstairs. And what was the result? We put a load with 170 kilo on this structure. We stopped it because we had no interest to destroy it. And for us, it was very impressive. This structure, only wooden structure, is less than 1 kilo. Huh? This, if you compare the material to the performance, then it's really exciting. And for us, it's very important because this natural structures, they had an evolutionary process about 300 million years behind. And if we go in our labs and we do 1,000 cycles, then it's in comparison to the nature, it's nothing. No? That's, the question is for us, where is the intelligence? Is the intelligence in our lab, or maybe the intelligence is in the material? Okay, we won a prize for this new structure. It's not a structure only for this tool. We can work with the structure maybe for larger structures, for architectural structures. The second project we did with the Team Austria, it was a competition between 20 universities. From Austria, 170 participants, students, professors, and experts from the industry worked with us creating this building. It was a competition called Solar Decathlon in California. And our task was, and our goal was to use as much from a tree as possible, because nowadays we're using only the massive wood, and the leaves and the roots and the bark we leave in the forest or we throw away. And here are some images from the construction site in the US. And our motivation was to show what means prefabrication, what means if you have only 10 days time to build this architecture on site, and what means communication between the students, professors, and the employees on the construction site. And in this situation, the students were responsible for the communication too. They have to explain their ideas. And Solar Decathlon means you have 10 categories. You can see this here with the different colors from architecture over marketing, build, engineering, communication, affordability, comfort zone, hot water, appliances, home entertainment, energy balance. Every different aspect was calculated, and we were in the lucky situation to win the race. And one of the aspects or one of the reasons we won this competition, we used the intelligence of these natural materials, and we are working with the performance of these materials. The design concept was to have very high, to have high touch surfaces and to have high tech in the behind the surface. And here you can see the one of the visitors, and this was the first time we used this new material made out of bark on the surfaces. And if you have a visitor smiling while he is touching the new material, then you know you did something right. In the interior, we also showed what can we do with the sawdust or with bark. We can create totally different surfaces. And this was the Austrian way how we show the Americans they should live in future. 90% of this building was produced out of wood. We called it LEASY, that means living inspired by sustainable innovation. You can see large sliding doors opening the whole walls, and they were hidden in some of the technical parts. This was one of the final days when we won the competition. And it was for me very emotional to see that people are waiting 2-3 hours to see this building for 10 minutes, and that we are able to tell our story about sustainable building, sustainable constructions. This was a reaction in the Los Angeles Times. They said it's an indoor-outdoor beauty that seems tailor-made for Santa Monica or the Hollywood Hills. And we had a huge reaction from the media, from architects, from designers all over the world. This gave us the energy for the next project. It was a competition too between 21 universities in Europe. And it was about the 500 years of Reformation in Wittenberg. The theme they gave us for the Gate 4 was justice, peace, and protection of creation. In the first seconds, we had no idea what to do. And then we had this discussion with my colleagues and with students. And we said, maybe between justice or behind justice, peace, and protection of creation, it's everything, every time about resources and how we share resources. The concept was to create four different areas with four different emotions. The motivation for our team was to raise awareness, to inform the people and to motivate them to interact with our installation. This is the plan from Wittenberg, the very old city, of course, and we got this area with a lake and with a small surrounding around this lake. We come up with an idea and say, okay, we have some troubles in Europe and not only in Europe. And how can we interact with these troubles in this situation? And we come up with this idea to have floating structures in the lake. We brought in one original refugee ship from Sicily. This was a very interesting journey, from Sicily to Wittenberg. And we developed two workshop pavilions and four domes, and we call them sacred spaces for discussion, for interaction during our presentation. The first time I went to through Wittenberg, I took some pictures for the research, and I found this ceiling in one of the churches, and I had my personal goal was to bring this structure in reality, let me say. This is the final concept, just to compare the inspiration and the interpretation. And the same situation in context of architecture, to bring this stone back to nature. And now I'm going through some of the findings. We organized 6 international workshops, and the task was nearly the same like in our situation for the Happiness Pavilion now in during the workshop. I was looking for a design DNA. That means we brought to the different workshop locations the same material. That means 4 meter long wooden sticks, 4 centimeter by 4 millimeter. And I told them that it's forbidden to do research. It's forbidden to do sketches, no models, no machinery. They have to start working immediately. Some of the students took part, some of our professors took part, and the rest of the team, they have to hire just directly on site. They have to ask people to help them. They find refugees, they find homeless people. And the interesting point was, it was not necessary for me to be there and to tell them what they should work. I only asked them to produce floating structures, they have the shapes like boats. And it was very successful. That means we did these workshops in Barcelona, Istanbul, Paris, Mulhouse, and of course Kuchl. And here you can see the final results. They had a lot of fun. They went with the structure through the city, in this situation through Barcelona or this through Kuchl. And the interesting point was, no machinery means during the workshop it was not very loud. That means the people started to interact, started the discussion. And of course, in the end, most of them became friends. The second area was this area with these 4 domes. We call it sacred spaces because, of course, they are useless. Their only motivation was to create very nice structures. Some images, we did the research on our campus. And it was very inspiring and very interesting to have this wooden stripes scale 1-to-1, because then you start to interact with the real material. And it's totally different if you have the material wood in a scale 1-to-100 or 1-to-50 or 1-to-100. Or if you go in the dimension 1-to-1. On this image, you see the first prototype. For half a year, this prototype was standing on our campus to see what is the how it reacts in the different weather conditions from winter to summer. And will it survive? These are some images from the workshop pavilions. They were prefabricated in Kuchl, and then we brought them by trucks to Wittenberg and finished them there. Some images from the wooden stripes we prepared in Kuchl. And in this area, it wasn't allowed to use concrete or to build a very, very massive structure. And it was, and they told us in the end of the exhibition, everything should be like it was before. That means we have to develop the whole circle to build it and to replace it in the end. Here can see we mounted this wooden plates directly with very huge screws directly in the soil. Here you can see wooden sticks more than 25 meters. We had to watering them because they are much flexible now later on. And if you have wooden stripes more than 25 meters, you have no possibility to transport them through the city. Okay, this was one of our tasks to find a transport system in Wittenberg. We found a very cheap one. Two shopping venture cost us €2 for four persons per day. And of course you can bring them back again. And this was part of the concept to show the people in Wittenberg, okay, there is something ongoing and there are crazy Austrians coming to Germany and they produce a special exhibition there. It looks in the end very handmade and low tech, but of course we have to do all the calculation and it was very precise how to bring these wooden sticks together without a crane, only by manpower, let me say. And you can see here some details. It was necessary to mount all these wooden stripes only by a rope. No gluing systems, no surface treatment. Biodegradable. Okay, and of course the media communication aspect in the end, and okay, party time. To sum up, this picture shows the original refugee ship from Sicily, more than 20 tons. These were the floating structures in the lake. It was very inspiring because when the wind was going through them, they were moving. Then we had these workshop pavilions, work with the visitors immediately if they are interested in new structures, new materials. We had the interaction immediately. And this is one picture of these four domes. And it was for me to feel the relationship between the human nature and the nature we are dealing with. That means for me, it was very, very important that the surface is nature, the top is nature, and we are working with our architecture in between. And of course, in the end, we had to rebuild everything. And now you can see it's going technically in the biological circle. And many people asked us, do you need help? And of course we need help. And in the end we worked together with people from Wittenberg. It was not only exhibition, it was a world performance. To come to an end, for me, intelligent solution means that our solutions do not provoke the next problem. This was the image, I took this image 4 hours before the opening ceremony. And for me, this was the proof of concept that nature is back. Thank you for listening. This is the end of my presentation.